Bro, I'm a fucking football noob. I am the worst noob of them all. I know nothing. I am learning. You know what's fire? That they're like it's two goats playing at the same time. That's the that I wish for, like, Ron, like, MJ, like that.
Has he been on the back? Seeing Ronaldo is something special. He's athletic, quick, and one of the better finishers. He can also use...
What the f***? I thought it was an edit! Oh my God! Who's your goat? What the fuck is... What y'all got? Chat. What do you think this video would tell me? Click it, bro. What do you think is going to be the conclusion by the end of this video, bro? Yeah, who's your GOAT?
Since the beginning of this...
That Neymar was him at 1.2, right? I remember being in high school and talking about some Neymars and shit. Bro, and that nigga Paul was on Messi, Neymar, Tommy, like, yo,
the
Neymar
world
is
football
him.
Has been blessed with two of the greatest who have ever played. They've dominated trophies, statistics, thus debates.
Okay.
Although it's hard to decide who's better.
You know what's fire? That they're like it's two goats playing at the same time. That's the that I wish for, like, Ron, like, MJ, shit like that. Kobe involved too. I mean, Kobe kind of had both, the best of both worlds. He dibbled and dabbled in both types. That was kind of fire, Kobe. Yo, Kobe's my favorite GOAT, bro. He's my favorite GOAT. He's just my favorite GOAT. You know what I'm saying? He's my favorite legend, bro. Who do I think the GOAT is? Who do you think I think the GOAT is? Okay, not D-Rose. D-Rose's my favorite player of all time. That's something different. Alright. I'm talking about LeBron or MJ. Y'all should know. I'm not even gonna answer the question. I ain't even gonna answer it, but, like, you know what I'm saying?
Tiger Woods.
By the end of this video, one guy will have the edge. This is the definitive comparison of Messi and Ronaldo.
If Messi was an NBA player, chat, what type of player would he be? Would he be like a Steph Curry? Would he be like a Westbrook? Would he be like a Ricky Rubio ass nigga? I'm not Rubio. Like a passing ass nigga, a shooting ass nigga, handle ass nigga.
Awards and the eye
defense ass nigga.
First off, who is one?
Curry? Like a Steve, yeah, I'm about to say like Nat, like a Nash ass nigga. Rajon Westbrook. John Stockton. Ooh, okay. Bro, chat, I know y'all hate the comparison, bro. I've been seeing it on the Twitter a lot. But y'all have to come to terms. Obviously not 100%, but very similar. Luka and Harden, bro. Their game, like prime Harden, not current, like prime Harden. The game is so similar, bro. It's so similar, bro. The game is so similar, bro. I'm telling you. I know y'all don't see it, but you gotta really watch a breakdown, bro. The game is, like, I see niggas in the comments tight as f-. I'm like, bro, that's not even a bad thing, though, bro. It's not even a bad thing. The only problem I have with that, Luka just more consistent in the playoffs for me. Luka just way more consistent in the playoffs. That's it. The only difference to me is Luka's more consistent in the playoffs. Harden was able to do that shit in the playoffs all the time. Then, yeah, Harden got too many bullshit ass playoff bullshit. Harden got too many bullshit ass playoff games. That pissed me. Oh, I wanted Harden to win so many times, bro. That shit pissed me off.
On the most. Winning can't make you the greatest, but it can make you one of the greatest.
Harden couldn't work the post? No. Harden definitely could work the post. After a while.
Simply put, winning six Champions League titles like Paolo Maldini will not make you the greatest. Ran. But sure, a notable figure.
He for sure could, though.
With this in mind, three subpoints will be awarded in accordance with their three common competitions: European, domestic, and international. Beginning with European, the most prestigious trophy in clubs is the UEFA Champions League title.
Yo, what am I learning?
Ronaldo has won it 5 times, whereas Messi has won it 4 times. While this is the official count, we commonly subtract one from Messi since he only started 2 games of his first official victory. Conversely, Ronaldo's 5 titles came in his presence, and he won them on 2 different teams.
Oh shit. That's kinda comp. That's kinda comp.
One subpoint for Ronaldo.
That's kinda comp. Bro, I'm a fucking football noob. I am the worst noob of them all. I know nothing. I am learning. I just learned about the shoot house that they gonna do. The shootout? The shootout? My nigga? no more draws or some shit. I don't know when that happened, but you know what I'm saying?
Advancing into domestic titles, Messi has won more league titles, domestic cups, more domestic super cups. Hence, there goes one for Messi. Lastly, the international number.
Okay, nigga.
Starting with Messi, let's just say he's a little unfortunate. However, it didn't start out that way. He began his journey by winning the 2005 Under-20 World Cup.
Okay.
He followed by a gold medal at the 2008 Olympics.
Fire.
But ultimately, his lack of performance at the 2010 World Cup hurt him. He did individually wield Argentina to the finals of the 2014 World Cup, but fell short in extra time against one of the best sides in recent history. He lost.
Was that more of a team diff right there? Was that a team diff or more of a messy thing here? Super team diff? Damn.
He did individually wield Argentina to the finals of the 2014 World Cup, but fell short in extra time against one of the best sides in recent history. He lost again at the 2018 World Cup in the hands of the soon-to-be champions by a score of 4-3.
What about here? Was the other team just more comp? Because they said soon to be world champs. It's always team diff.
At the 2018 World Cup in the hands of the soon-to-be champions by a score of 4-3. At South America's Continental Tournament.
What is it? Mbappe? Is it pronounced Mbappe? He said he cooked him. Why is it Mbappe cooked him? Y'all niggas.
The Copa America, he has never won. In his four presents, he's gone to the finals 2 times. In each one of these, he lost in penalties. On the other 2 times, in each one of these, he lost in penalties. On the other hand, Ronaldo has won 2 major trophies.
Not updated? Oh, this is 1 year old. This video is 1 year old. So that was wrong by just one right here? It'd be one because it's a 1 year old.
2016.
He won this year? All right, bet.
Euros and the 2019 Nations League. Even though he didn't win a single game in regular time at the 2016 Euros,
this could be updated if there's something off.
Portugal won this tournament is enough to give him a point.
Damn.
According to betting websites, Portugal's odds of winning were 20-1 at the start. That's 1 point for Ronaldo, which makes him the winner of my first criterion, winning.
So, everything to perspective, chat. Looking at just straight winning. Is this true? Is this true? Like in y'all opinion, have y'all been seeing shit? Have y'all since y'all been watching it? Does this look like facts to you when it comes to winning? Like in your brain, when you think of Ronaldo, Messi, like yeah, Ronaldo's team win more. Is that in your head? Like, do you see that or nah?
Yeah, I'd agree. Not anymore. Okay, bet.
Stats. Who got a better stats, chat?
My second criterion is statistics and advanced metrics. This part is divided by scoring and shooting, assist and shot creation, and impact on the team's performance.
Impact, oh, I like that. I like that stat. How the fuck do you track that? I like that stat.
Beginning with scoring
and shooting, plus minus.
We noticed that Ronaldo has more career goals, but he also played more games.
On some Bron Jordan shit. On some Bron Jordan shit. Ron got more points. Also got way more games and way more seasons, so you gotta put that into perspective.
And if we take away penalty goals, Messi already surpassed Ronaldo in 2018. Looking further into it, we find that Messi has a higher average goals per game. A common remark regarding their averages is that Ronaldo started his career in a tougher league, being the Premier League.
So wait, here's our score.
Regarding their averages is that Ronaldo started his career in a tougher league, being the Premier League. In spite of that, if we only consider the average goals per game in the Champions League, Messi still comes out on top. His goals are also more efficient, meaning he scores them on less attempted shots per game. That brings us to accuracy.
Well, I was about to say, maybe Ronaldo just has a better team, so he's not taking as many shots per game, but he didn't say he doesn't have better shots. Oh, he more efficient?
He scores them on less attempted shots per game. That brings us to accuracy metrics, and yes, Messi has a higher shot on target percentage, which is impressive considering his attempts come in farther from.
My nigga shooting 46% from the field, my nigga! He shooting 46%!
From the goal, as can be shown by his number of goals outside the box.
On target, yeah, that's what I meant. Same shit, on target. That's what I meant. On target, that's what I meant. That's pretty. That's some skill, bro. That's some.
And considering his attempts coming farther from the goal as can be shown by his number of goals outside the box. Furthermore, Messi has a better conversion from just about anywhere on the field.
Okay.
As for free kicks, they share the same number of free kick goals, but percentages and distance tell a different story. Messi has close to twice Ronaldo's free kick conversion, and his attempts come in farther than Ronaldo.
Okay, there has to be an explanation. There has to be an explanation, because these stats are a little bit too, you know what I'm saying, showing a little bit of my skill, you know what I'm saying? So hold on. Give me the explanation. Yo, Ronaldo fans, talk to me. Let's come to a conclusion. Okay, what is the reason? What is the reasoning? Talk to me. He's just better. Messi, just that guy.
Give me a stat that Ronaldo's better.
Their path to that number is very different. At the start of his career, Messi was without a doubt a poor free kick shooter. But recently, Messi seems to have become the best free kick shooter ever. No trending line could have predicted these latest numbers. He just flipped the switch.
How the fuck? Nigga on the lap? Wait, how the fuck he went from at, like, mid? How? He's cheated. Drug test. Nigga, what?
In sum, regarding scoring and shooting, though Ronaldo is frequently referred as the better shooter or finisher, Messi has the highest average goals per game on less attempted shots.
See, now that's okay. See, I can see how this goes, though. This is another like basketball like stat. Like, obviously, you see, like, Jordan is a better, like, shooter, like, better, like, shooter than LeBron, but it'll show, like, LeBron fucking, like, you know what I'm saying, scores more on less, you know what I'm saying, some shit like that. So, like, who do you think is better, who do you think is better in this stat, chat, from, without looking at stat, if you have to just envision your brain right here, who do you think is better at this stat right here? Like, if you didn't know the stats, if you're just watching the game, like, what would you think? Be real, Lance Stevenson.
Really?
Is it not one of those things where it's like, we look at LeBron, we look at Kobe, you look at Kobe as a shooter, but you look at the stats, you see LeBron technically has better shooting stats than Kobe, right? But still, you're going to say Kobe's a better shooter. It's not like that or not? No, it's just Messi, I bet.
Messi has the highest average goals per game on less attempted shots. He has a better conversion from everywhere, and he's the better free kick shooter. The only metric in Ronaldo's favor is his penalty conversion. Okay. Inevitably, Messi has one.
I ain't gonna lie. That's a cool little penalty conversion stat right now. But you know what I'm saying? Messi, get that motherfucker to Messi. That's tough.
Point.
That's a blot. What the fuck is a penaldo? Oh, penaldo penalty. Y'all niggas is stupid. You niggas is dumb.
For assists and shot creation, Messi has the most assists per 90 minutes. In contrast to popular beliefs, Ronaldo has some incredible numbers, but in assists, Messi is second to none, as he holds the highest career assist total.
See? Ronaldo is him! Ronaldo's right there, bro. He's ahead of all these niggas. But Messi's just him. Messi's just him. What the fuck? But, listen, is it because he had, like, better players to assist to? Or nah? And in less games. Oh, Jesus Christ. Yo. They both had great teams? Because he's like a... God damn. And he's younger than... Yo.
Possession and dribbling, although dribble stats only exist since 2017, Messi has always been first in every major category.
Jesus.
Carries, total distance, total progressive distance,
carries
that enter the last third of the pitch, carries that enter the box, and what I'll refer as the Messi stat, the number of players dribble past.
Look at Neymar going crazy. But that top. Where's Ronaldo on this motherfucker? Where the other goat at? What other player do y'all love on here besides Messi, of course? What other player here y'all fuck with tough?
Messi had Henry, Neymar, Ronaldinho, Xavi, Iniesta, Ibra. Bro had the Avengers on his squads.
WTF you're on.
Chat.
He's still better toe.
Chat. What you got to say about that? Chat, he said he had the Avengers. What's up? He said he had 2017 Golden State Warriors. What's up?
Such dribbling and fast.
Yo, y'all gonna make me want to watch this shit, bro. Yo, what's the next World Cup game?
That I could watch, not like 5 a.m. shit, bro.
Fuck.
5 a.m.? What time? Get on time, and Jens, I'm about to be on time, bro. Y'all niggas about to make me on time, bro.
I'm convinced Ronaldo fans just have a crush on him. The same way Shy fans have a crush
what
on
teams?
Him, so they decried with no hands.
Spain versus Germany. Who y'all got? Who y'all want to win Spain versus Germany? Who y'all want to win that?
In basketball terms, Messi is LeBron and Ronaldo is MJ. In football terms, Ronaldo is Tom Brady and Messi is Aaron Rodgers. In baseball terms, I don't know who the fuck watches baseball.
This ain't Lono.
Is he the best dribbler of all time? Trust he will have you hyped.
USA got a match on Tuesday! Chat, we are locked in! Against who? Chat, we are locked in! USA got a match against who?
Iran? Yo, what is that? Is that GG Nori? What is that? Talk to me. What Iran looking like? Is Iran butt? If they lose or draw, we don't make it. Is Iran pussy? Talk to me. Are they pussy? Are they whack? We shitting on them niggas. I put money on it too, fuck nigga. We shitting on them niggas. I don't even know who they players is, nigga. We shitting on them niggas, boy. Well, I put money up too, nigga.
Street saying it's a mid off.
Yo, is it a bit off?
Bro, yo, chat. Why y'all don't fuck with our own country, bro? Y'all don't be fucking with your own country, bro. Y'all be fucking with Argentina more than USA, bro.
Harrison after this.
Yo, Americans be fucking with other countries teams more than they. Yo, man. Americans do not give a fuck about no soccer, bro.
Such dribbling and passing abilities help Messi create shot options for his teammates. So of course he's going to be better than Ronaldo in goal creating actions per 90 minutes. But I'd like to point out that Messi doesn't have the highest score here. That feat belongs to Neymar.
Neymar like that?
Similarly, an interesting stat worth of showing is expected goals. An expected goal would be a penalty or a tap-in. An unexpected goal would be a free kick or a 20-yard carry.
Neymar's
thus,
him?
We measured
I don't know, somebody's naming the way he looked, bro.
Number of goals over the
no,
number
on,
of
no
expected
shit.
Goals. Subsequently, there are some players who have negative expected goals. That would mean that they didn't capitalize on wide-open nets, for example.
Okay.
On that note, Messi has by far the better goal over expected goals per 90 minutes. Briefly, being the better passer, dribbler, and playmaker, Messi takes home this point. As for the impact on the team's performance...
Okay, talk to me.
We measure it in a statistic called Team Success On-Off. This metric works by taking the number of goals scored per 90 minutes while the player is
plus minus.
On the pitch.
Plus minus, talk to me!
The number
plus
of
minus,
goals
talk to me!
While the player is off the pitch.
Off the pitch.
As a result, Messi's at 0.75 while Ronaldo is at 0.60. In other words, when Messi is on the pitch, there are 0.75 more goals being scored. Nonetheless, this metric is only available since 2014. If anything, Messi is the winner again.
Oh, fuck.
Okay.
In 2019, a Belgian university by the name of KU Leuven published a study...
I'm so biased. Tell me how it's biased.
Actions speak louder than goals. In this document, the university describes a...
Jenny said, Ronaldo, ST, to be fair. What's an ST? A starting back? A strat? A small tort? Oh, a striker. And what's Messi?
Alright, so that's... Wing.
Okay, you're a winger. Say that.
testing the impact of metrics via machine learning in a plethora of data. Their metrics compile passes by distance, dribble by distance, shots by distance, free kicks by distance, penalties, penalties provoke, interceptions, clearances, crosses, fouls, tackles, corners, and many more.
Talk to me.
There are also other components such as the game state, which calculates the value of an action based on the difficulty of scoring or defending in the game. All of these metrics are unified by the label Soccer Player Action Description Language, or SPADL for short. Thereby, when we multiply the number of actions per 90 minutes and the average value per actions, we get the ultimate number, the VAEP.
Okay, get that VORP. Let's go, let's get the VORP.
Unfortunately, players' VAEP have only been calculated for the study's preceding year, which is the 2017-18 season. That said, Ronaldo has a VAEP of 0.61, but Messi has nearly twice that at 1.21. As you can see on the board, Messi is not here right now. Now he is. Although this was a sample of one single season, that won't be a problem since Messi placed 5th in the Ballon d'Or votes. That was his worst position since 2006, where he was 19 years of age. It's not that Ronaldo's bad, Messi's just really good, and if there's a way to evaluate actions on a pitch, he will tower over everybody else. As for the VAEP, it wasn't maintained for three different reasons. It's too long, too complicated, and too expensive. Until there's an advanced optical reading software that can read the pitch, 2017-18 will remain the best season for stats, and we know who's at the top.
That's so fire. Oh my god, that's so fire. Oh my god, I wish they kept that. That is fire. That ESPN has stat is fire.
In a few words, as far as stats go, Messi takes another one home.
Jesus Christ.
Also, if statistics is the only thing that matters, Messi is not only the greatest player of all time, but the greatest that ever will be. There will probably never be a statistical anomaly like Messi ever again.
Oh, so he wins the stats, okay? Winning goes to, okay, so you got the stats category. You got the stats category. You got the stats category. Okay. So you got stats.
As for awards and
that was an evisceration. Let's be quite clear, chat. That was an evisceration. For the stats, that was an evisceration.
Honors. Whether Messi or Ronaldo ends up winning this one, they are by far the two most individually decorated footballers of all time.
So the MJ stat right here.
In individual awards, most
Michael Jordan stat right here. The awards.
The FIFA Best, the European Golden Boot, and the Ballon d'Or. Summing these up would tell you that Messi has the edge, but with 13 and 14 awards, they're both lonely at the top. Starting with the Golden Boot, which rewards Europe's top goalscorer, Messi has 6 while Ronaldo has 4.
Okay, so you got a scoring title, you know what I'm saying? You got more scoring
titles.
As
for the FIFA Best, the count is 4-3 in the favor of Ronaldo.
What's FIFA Best? How do you get this award? Is this like MVP? I feel like this is like MVP. Best award of all time. So he has more MVPs? Okay. It's a clout competition.
For the FIFA Pro World 11, or the Team of the Year as FIFA puts it, they both share an outstanding 14 appearances.
Jesus. Is this like all team? Is this some all team, all NBA shit right here?
Ronaldo was awarded the IFFHS top goalscorer of the decade, while Messi was awarded the best playmaker of the decade and the best player of the decade. Messi has won the FIFA World Cup Golden Ball in 2014, which rewards the best player in the World Cup.
Okay.
Ronaldo has won the Ons d'Or 2 times, while Messi has won it 4 times.
What's the Ons d'Or? Talk to me about the Ons d'Or. What's the Ons d'Or?
That being said, the most prestigious individual honor is the Ballon d'Or. As a result, Messi has 6, while Ronaldo has 5.
Oh, shit.
Interestingly, when Messi won his 6th Ballon d'Or, separating him...
Messi has 7 now, though, right? It should be 7-5 right now, right? Since it's like a year late. Or am I wrong? Should it be 7? Since like a year off? Yep. Locked in.
...himself from Ronaldo, it was the first time that he ever acknowledged his competitiveness with Ronaldo, saying... When Cristiano Ronaldo pulled level with me, I'll admit that it hurt a little as I was no longer alone at the top. But at that moment, he deserved a Ballon d'Or, and I couldn't do much more about it.
Ballon d'Or.
As for the awards criteria, Messi wins another one.
Okay. Eye test. From your perspective, if you were to just watch, I'm not talking about the stats, I know you know the stats now and shit. If you were just watching both, you were watching Ronaldo, you watched a game of Ronaldo, you watched a game of Messi. They both scored like one goal or some shit. Who would you say was better? Be real. They both scored the same amount of goals and shit. But just watching them, be like, yeah, that nigga's better. What are you going, chat? See what chat says. Vote up.
Okay.
Chat, y'all taking Iguodala? I'm taking Iguodala, bro.
The eye test is what I would define as the best player to watch. Seeing Ronaldo is something special. He's athletic, quick, and one of the better finishers. He can also use...
What the fuck?! I thought that was an edit! What the shit?! This athletic...
The eye test is what I would define as the best player to watch.
Yo!
Though he's something
special. Oh my god!
Athletic.
Yo. They got it, bro. These soccer niggas got it. But the nigga said. Yo, nah, these soccer niggas got it, bro. Hit that shit with his head too? Face ass nigga. Chat, I want you to go in the VOD and look what just happened. I've had this string in my hand. I've been playing with it because it came off like the hoodie string or whatever. I did this. I did this and it went perfectly down my throat and I whipped it out. I see black dots. Oh my god! In a millisecond, I did this. And it's wet. And I pulled it out. How did... I need y'all to go on VOD and try to zoom and see what just happened, bro. Oh my god! How did that happen? I'm not practicing for nothing, bro. Stop it. Wordle?
It was his head, unlike Messi. A thing that your eyes will tell you, which you won't find in numbers, is that Ronaldo was probably a better player with Manchester United. Indeed, his numbers weren't as good as afterwards, but he was scoring more free kicks, he dribbled a little better, he scored outside the box more frequently,
oh shit, that was a
he
fire
was
move.
A more skilled player
oh
all
god.
Around.
Oh my god, yet, oh my god, United, oh my god, what the shit was that? Why you mix up? He tween, has he tween, 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 has he been on the back,
tween, cross, pale cross, compared oh, to his tween, at Real Madrid and Juventus. The reason why would that be can also be found
yo,
in the
how do you
eye
do
test.
That?
The fact of the matter...
How do you do that shit, bro? Them niggas be... Like, how do you do that shit, bro? How you not trip over the ball and bust your ass, nigga? How the fuck do you do that shit, bro? While running full speed!
...is that Ronaldo was better surrounded in Real Madrid and Juventus.
How the fuck they got the clip already, bro? Let's see. I can't zoom. I hope this shows, bro. Chat, I hope it shows, bro. Face ass, nigga. Nigga. Hit that shit with his head, too? You. Face ass. How did it go on there, nigga? It's about... Oh, my God. It was in my throat at this point. How? How? How the fuck? Yo, no, let's slow down. Hit that shit with his head too? You. Face ass, nigga. No, bro. Hit that shit with his head too. You. Face ass, nigga. I think the, like, since I was like, and like, it just sucked it up or some shit.
Throat demon, bro.
Bro, that was bad.
That was bad. That was bad.
A high rate of his goals came via tap in, which is the type of goals that you didn't see him score very often with the Reds. That's nothing against him. Some tap ins require a great deal of skills, even if they're not as enjoyable to watch. The unpleasant side in Ronaldo's games lies in his volume of shots. As established before, compared to Messi,
he's a high volume shooter.
He has a lesser average goals per game while having the higher attempted shots per game.
Sometimes
he makes you wonder if his presence can hurt a possession.
Yo, what were some of them shots? What?
Messi, he has a lesser average goals per game while having the higher attempted shots per game. Sometimes he makes...
What? Am I tripping? What the fuck is this?
Read Dono. Messi has always played on the best team and the players in the world since his debut, which boosts his stats a lot. Ronaldo started his career in a weak league, then played on the best team for a few years, then on mid-teams with a lot of mid-teammates.
Is that facts? That's what the Dono just said. There's another Dono right here.
2026 World Cup is in USA, Canada, and Mexico. So YRG have 4 years to be a lock-in. I hope USA will be on timing. Also, I am a Ronaldo / Brazil fan. Messi is a goat, but Ronaldo is my goat.
Yeah, we're going to a World Cup game in 2026.
Sir, average goals per game while having the higher attempted shots per game.
Like, what the fuck was that one?
Sometimes he makes you wonder if his presence can hurt a possession.
Or maybe Spedastono Messi makes his teammates better. Ronaldo just a tap-in merchant, not my goat.
How you feel about that one, chat?
In contrast, Messi gets you the best play possible for every possession. His mission is to have the ball in the goal by the
Jesus
end of the
Christ
season.
That, yo!
The best play possible for
chat.
Every possession. His mission is to have the
Oh my god, bro!
The ball in the goal by the end of the sequence, regardless of his implication. When he was
he set that
of a
nigga up for fucking
in 2012, he scored an all-time record of 91 goals for the year. When he was a midfielder in 2019, he racked up an all-time record of 21 assists for a season. He is a purely positionless and selfless offensive player. Ronaldo can conclude great plays. Messi creates his own and remains the better finisher of the two. Even though they have a close percentage in success...
These passes, bro!
Seeing them play will reveal you that Messi is much more venturous with the ball. As you can see here, Messi takes the ball behind
fucking
midfield.
Dimes.
He dribbles through one.
Oh my god.
Two.
Kyrie,
still with
yes.
the ball. Three.
Nigga.
And four.
What?
He enters the last third of the pitch and makes a perfect pass to his teammate. Highlights won't show that, and basic stats cannot count this action. As dominant as Messi is in statistics, numbers don't really do him justice. If Messi.
Bro, did this nigga just say this nigga's so good that even though his goated ass stats don't do him justice, my boy? Is that basically what the fuck this bitch ass nigga just told me? Did your bitch ass just tell me this nigga's so good the stats don't give him justice even though he got the best stats on the fucking planet, my boy?
Messi dribbled like everybody else. He would simply never lose the ball.
Jesus.
Or as Ray Hudson puts it.
How do you put statistics on this, Phil?
You think he run faster than me, chat? You think Messi run faster than me?
This is the art of human.
Be real.
Actions like this are the reason why Messi has the higher career average match rating and likewise the highest since the metric's inception. This is also why Messi has the highest number of men of the match and incidentally, the most since the metric's inception.
Man of the match? So it's like the game player of the game type shit? How they be in 2K? Damn. So the Dono said that Ronaldo had worse teammates than Messi. If that's the case, why does he have more player of the matches? Dono told me Messi had way better teammates. If that's the case, it should boost this nigga player of the matches. You know what I'm saying?
In the end, That tug of war is won by Messi. Ronaldo is undoubtedly one of the greatest to ever lace.
Warriors fans. Bro, I already know every Steph Curry, Draymond Green, fucking Klay Thompson Warriors fan seeing this number and they fucking heart drop. Every time you just see 3-1, your heart drops. And it's not even, like, it's just not even your fault. Like I don't blame you, bro. Like, that like 3-1 will forever, undoubtedly, just be engraved in your soul, in all of our souls. And I'm not even a Warriors fan like that, my boy. I just enjoy them, you know? So, like, that's tough. That's tough.
Ronaldo is undoubtedly one of the greatest to ever lace up. Messi is just that Asian kid that's
PTSD.
Always better than you.
Oh, that's... No, that was... Why'd you have to add that at the end, nigga? What the fuck was that about?
Ronaldo is undoubtedly one of the greatest to ever lace up. Messi is just that Asian kid that's always better than you.
Okay, so the video was mad professional the whole way through. It was nice, the instrumental in the background, the voice, the words he was using.
You know that Asian kid that was always better than you? Where the fuck did that come from, bro?
I mean, I don't think Asians take offense to that, because you just calling them nigga smart as fuck. But goddamn, nigga! What the fuck? What the shit?
Although it won't affect the scoreboard, I think it's the appropriate video to talk about the people's opinion on the topic. In the light of this video, I made a list of every known players, managers, owners, and commentators who expressed their side on the Messi-Ronaldo debate. Here's all the people I've found. Now, in all 141 personalities, 110 voted for Messi and 31 for Ronaldo. That is, if we account everybody mentioned. If we subtract the ones who played or coached one or the other to erase any possible conflict of interest, it's now 89-10. Whoa, I'm bitched up, I drip when I walk. I'm bringing pressure around when I walk. I kicked the bitch out of the G, told her walk. As for the public, the largest poll on the internet is found on the Messi vs. Ronaldo website, accounting for more than 1 million voices. Messi Damn. Has 655,000 of them, while Ronaldo has 360,000. In other words, it's 65% to 35%. To finish, as I have the word GOAT in the title, some of you are probably irritated, mainly because of two greats, Pele and Maradona. On that account,
we got a nigga. There's a nigga GOAT? There's a nigga GOAT in this sport? There's a nigga GOAT in this sport? Is he far? Is he far? Chad, is he far? Pele played with plumbers.
How do Messi and Ronaldo compare to them? Let's see. Starting off with Maradona. Both Messi and Ronaldo have better stats than him all across the board. In fact, they both have more than twice Maradona's goals total.
God damn.
That being said,
that
when Maradona carried his team to a World Cup win, he seemed to be the greatest ever. But he didn't maintain that level of playing outside the World Cup. You can see here that Maradona doesn't really rival Messi and Ronaldo's goals per 90 minutes. Stats don't really put Maradona in the debate. He was more of a showman.
I don't know why I hate comparing it with generations and shit, like, you know what I'm saying? Oh, he died? I just be picturing, imagine the niggas that were demons in the 1970s or 1980, whatever the fuck. In this day and age of knowledge and technology and the, like, way you could take care of your body and workouts and the knowledge of the past. Imagine how demonoid they'd be, bro. Like, imagine Michael Jordan in 2022. He gets to learn and watch from all the great from the 1900s. The best workouts, the best training, the best... The nigga would be a god. The nigga would be a fucking god. The nigga would have had a three-point... Imagine that nigga coming into the league with a three-point pull-up. Oh, my... Like, what? Even the fucking seven-foot niggas can shoot these days because they know as a G, you got to work on this, got to work on this, got to train, got to train, got to train, got to train. Like, bro, nigga would be... Jesus Christ.
Oh man, just like Ronaldinho.
Like, imagine Will. Oh my, I don't even want to think about Leo. Like, bro. Like, Will, oh my. Like, that's low key why I hate comparing generate. Like, shit like that, because, like, you can't. Like, just
times are just way different, bro. Just way, like, how the world, shit's just way different, bro.
And as for his longevity, how much can we blame Flower? In my eyes, his career totals are simply insufficient. Conversely, with Pele, I'll start by saying this. In the Pele. Years to come, as sports hold more history, GOAT debates will shift from the best player ever to the best player relative to his peers. Nowadays, of course, players run faster, jump higher, shoot better. Is Messi a better player than Pele ever was? Probably. But if the GOAT debate is about the most dominating player respective to his era, we have a debate. Three World Cups are hard to come by in any era. As for their stats, at least the one they share, they're pretty similar. But in recent history, Pele has made a fool of himself. For over 40 years, Pele held the record for the most goals total and the most goals total for one club. In a span of 2 weeks, Messi broke one and Ronaldo the other. In the light of these achievements, Pele, with the help of his former club Santos, released a statement saying that his club total at Santos was actually in four figures, at 1,091 goals. He also updated his Instagram bio saying that his goals total stands at 1,283. The thing is that 526 goals of that number would have come from unofficial friendlies and tour games. Funny enough, he even counted games he played in a military competition.
Look here, Peter. Let the new niggas get it, bro. They got it. They got it. Your time has come. You will forever be remembered, but what the fuck are you doing, my boy? What the fuck you got going on? Talking about some backyard buckets and shit, my nigga. Huh?
In the eyes of the level-minded, Pele has 644 for a single club and 757 for a career. He is great, but not unreachable.
It was amazing, but you know, I'm saying shit happens.
Thank you for making it till the end. This is the first major video on this channel.
Is it because he was Brack? Yo,
no,
chill.
No, I'm gonna make another one.
Play Warzone with Kai. It's Kai Warzone. Oh, God, I hope I'm Warzone with Kai. Please tell me these niggas playing Warzone, bro.
Leave a like if you will.
I want to play Warzone so bad.
It helps.
You not? I bet. Yo, Abdi!
Said I'm on 3+ right now, if I'm being honest. Hope my feelings shoot out like a rocket. Niggas thought they had the swag, but I'm really on it. Look at you just window shopping that new bag I bought.